things, Justin's doing a lot of good things, but one of the things that's given him the opportunity to play for us is his composure and making plays under duress. And so, you know, he's showing us every indication that he can play against any type of defense. You know, his decision-making process for a freshman is pretty special. You know, how to, because that's the whole thing to be a quarterback, really in any offense, how fast you can process things and make quick decisions. And he's done that well, and he did a couple times against Cal for big runs for us.
When you look at the film from last week, what slowed Royce down? What did you see? Was it, do you think he was healthy, or was it something they were doing?
I think it was a combination of things. I think it was something that they were doing. I thought they did a good job. Add an extra guy to the box to try to take away the runs. And, you know, our run game was kind of hit and miss. We had some big ones, and there was some that we didn't. And then, you know, Royce is a lot healthier this week than he was last week.
Seems like he's been taken down more in the backfield than we've seen in the past. We're getting hit at least in the backfield, not getting the line of scrimmage than we've seen in the past.
Yeah, again, that's obviously you guys see the running back. Sometimes that might be a miscommunication up front or something good that, you know, California did.
Statistically, Arizona State is the best run defense in the conference. Is that a no one's running because they're blitzing so much and everyone's passing on them, or are they actually a pretty stout run?
They're pretty good against the run. You know, they're a good defensive football team. They're a very aggressive team, and so, you know, and you got to match aggressiveness with aggressiveness, and it's a big challenge for our guys. Our guys are excited about it, but yeah, their stats kind of speak for themselves.
We got after Luke Falk pretty good last week. I think 7 sacks in that one. I think you saw that film. What were they doing well that allowed them to get the quarterback?
I think it's a combination of things. I think, you know, they're very good at pressuring the quarterback schematically, but I also think they've got good personnel up front. Some of those sacks were just their defensive ends beating their offensive tackles. So it's going to be a challenge to us. Now, another thing, Washington State throws a lot. So when you throw it that much, you're going to be prone to more sacks. But, yeah, it's a challenge for our guys. We've got to be excited about it. That's the thing. When you play an aggressive defense like these guys, and it happened last year, there's going to be some – we never want to have a negative play, but there might be a no-deep play. Okay? And the biggest thing is – just keep punching, and then eventually you're going to connect with one. And that's kind of our mindset, you know. Happened against Cal, where every once in a while we'd have a no-game play. That's football. They're on scholarship too. But the key is just keep playing and play the next play, and then good things usually happen. You can have that mindset.
Is this about where you wanted your offensive line to be at this point in the season? Coming into the season, was kind of the expectation where they're at right now?
I think for 4 redshirt freshmen, to perform that way, I've been very happy with the way they perform. They've gotten better each week, and their mindset and work ethic has been great.
Touching on Royce again, what are you seeing at practice this week that makes you feel like maybe he's a little healthier or ready than he's been in past weeks?
He's running full speed. You know, running full speed. The amount of reps he's taken, you know, we're giving him his regular share of reps. He's handling them well, and he's finishing runs, you know, like Royce normally does. So just a combination of those things are giving us a lot of confidence. I think giving him, more importantly, giving him confidence that he's 100% ready to roll.